Hey everybody, Pastor Greg here. I hope that you're all doing well and that you've had a great summer with family and friends. Well, can you believe it? We're already into September. I know for so many of you, September is a crazy time. It is for our family. School is starting up again soon, and so many families right now are choosing either to send their kids back to school in person or they're doing school online. At this time of year as well, there's a lot of sports and other programs starting up again. It's a busy time. And for us here at Redeemer, September is no exception. Because starting this coming Tuesday, September 8th, Redeemer is officially opening up to the public. Since COVID-19 started back in early mid-March, our church building has been closed in the sense that we haven't been doing any ministries or programs or events of any kind, but that's all going to change starting next week. No, we're not yet ready to open for Sunday morning services at Redeemer, but Redeemer is officially open to the public in that starting next week, we are beginning to host certain ministry events and programs here at Redeemer. So what does it mean for all of us now that Redeemer is on the cusp of reopening our building? What will events look like? And what will it look like to say, like say, if you just wanted to stop by the church at all? That's what this reopening update is all about. So I just want to take some time right now to explain to you what reopening means and looks like here at Redeemer starting this coming Tuesday, September 8th. As it relates to all in-person gatherings and events that are open to the public that will take place here at Redeemer, there are certain protocols that we've put in place to help keep you and your family safe as much as we can. We want you to know that we take your health and safety very seriously when it comes to COVID-19. And so we have created the following protocols in line with what Ottawa Public Health and the Province of Ontario have both mandated and recommended as good practice. So let's say you were to attend a men's breakfast or an in-person small group gathering, or let's say you were just going to drop your kid off for our Redeemer Youth Alternative event, which is taking place outside this coming Wednesday, September 9th in the evenings. The following is what is required of you to attend that event so that you and everyone around you takes the proper precautions to stay safe. First off, everyone must pre-register for any in-person event or gathering at Redeemer. How you pre-register is you head to our website, redeemeralliance.ca, and both on our homepage and on our calendar page, there will be a button that reads, Register for an Event. You can click that button. It will lead you to a page listing all of the events taking place at Redeemer. And from there, you can click the event you want to register for, and you register. Now listen, this is important. You need to pre-register for every event that you want to attend at Redeemer. If you don't pre-register, then you will be unable to attend the event. Now, if you're not tech savvy or you don't have a computer or internet, you can still pre-register for an event by calling the event leader and they can pre-register you on our registration system over the phone. When you register online, there will be a waiver form that you must agree to, as well as a few yes or no questions. Finally, registration for every event will open up 1 week prior to the event starting, and registration will close the evening before by 11:30 p.m. Upon arriving at Redeemer to attend the in-person event or gathering that you register for, you will be required to do the following. At the front entrance of the church outside, you will be asked a series of screening questions before you enter the building. The questions are as follows. Number one, have you had any symptoms of COVID-19? Are you experiencing any symptoms that are abnormal to what you normally experience, like asthma, allergies, etc.? Question number two, have you come into close contact with a person who has COVID-19 or another person with symptoms of COVID-19 during the past 14 days? Question number three, have you traveled outside of Canada in the past 14 days? Question number four, if you were to develop symptoms up to 48 hours after an in-person event here at Redeemer, will you get tested for COVID-19 and contact us to let us know? If you had to answer any of the first three questions with a yes, then you would not be permitted to enter the building even though you pre-registered. Question four is simply you agreeing that if you were to develop any COVID-19 symptoms within 48 hours, you would agree to let us know and you would get tested. Finally, you will be required to sanitize your hands before entering the building. Now, upon entering the building, as per the present mandatory mask bylaw that is in force here in Ottawa, every person inside the church building for any given event has to wear a mask unless they are a small child under the age of two, or you have an underlying health condition whereby wearing a mask would exacerbate that underlying health condition. If there is food or drink at the event, participants will be permitted to take off their mask in order to eat and drink, but should wear a mask at all other times. Physical distancing of 2 meters must be maintained at all times, and there will be signage throughout the church building instructing people to maintain social distancing and wash and sanitize their hands. Hand sanitizer will be made available throughout the church building. In terms of us keeping the church clean, we are endeavoring to do that in a number of ways. First, the building will be cleaned once per week by a janitorial service. Secondly, sanitary wipes will be available in each bathroom. There will also be signage in the bathrooms instructing people to wipe down the surfaces they've used with the sanitary wipes. The event leader will also let people know that there are sanitary wipes in the bathroom and that they should be used to sanitize all surfaces that they've used. As well, every leader who is in charge of any event or gathering of any kind will ensure that all surfaces used during the event are sanitized after the event has ended. This is the protocol that we have put in place here at Redeemer so as to provide a safe and clean environment for every person who desires to attend an event or an in-person gathering here at Redeemer. Now, what if you're not attending an event or an in-person gathering at Redeemer and you're just stopping by? Great, you can do that as long as you do the following. Before you just stop by, call us here at the church and confirm with us that you're just stopping by. Maybe you want to have a conversation with myself or Pastor Dylan, one of the other staff. Great. Again, we welcome that, but you need to call ahead and book an appointment with us to do so. Don't just call ahead and leave a message. You have to call ahead, talk to a staff member here at Redeemer so as to book it as an appointment for us to know that you're coming. Upon entering the church building, you will be asked the screening questions, you'll be required to sanitize your hands and wear a mask, and your name and phone number will be taken for contact tracing purposes. Now, I recognize that this sounds like a lot. Maybe it sounds too complicated or too much to do. I hear you and I get it. But right now, this is just how it is. Make no mistake, we as the leadership team here at Redeemer have put these stringent measures in place so that we can provide you with a safe and clean environment where you can have the best experience possible during this challenging time when you come to Redeemer to attend an event or an in-person gathering. Here at Redeemer, we're all about loving each other and our community in Jesus' name. That's what our mission and our vision is all about. And one way we can continue to do that during this time is by following the protocols that our health authorities have put in place for our safety. This is not an easy time, I know, but let's keep praying that it gets better for the sake of our city, our province, and our country. And let's keep looking to God and trusting Him and living for Him by loving others with the love of Jesus. Have a great week, everybody, and God bless.